Greetings, friends and strangers alike. Welcome, one and all. I'm your friendly woodland elf, and welcome back to Gun. Now, there's something a little bit different about this episode, and that is that I am post-commentating it. For some reason, during this recording, my computer picked up the wrong mic. The recording software I used to record my mic picked up the wrong mic. It actually picked up the mic from my webcam instead of my actual USB mic. So that was annoying. So I'm sort of just re-watching this episode myself as I'm commentating this, trying to sort of remember what I was doing. I think at this point I was just sort of explaining what happened last time, which was we joined the resistance against a man called Thomas Magruder, who is apparently sort of a big player around these parts. And we set up an ambush on one of his trains, which is what we're looking at right now. And we killed all the men on board and secured a Gatling gun and also freed a cabin full of Indian slaves. So that's righteously pissed off Mr. Magruder. Or we assume, we haven't actually seen him since then. And also a little bit of random story. Well, not a little importance, I guess. And that's as we... And for some reason I fell off the cliff on my horse. Fantastic. as we freed the Apaches from their cabin, a leader came up and sort of berated us for killing a lot of Apaches previously in the story. And for some reason we could understand what he was saying, but we couldn't speak Apache. Little note of import there, which will appear in the story later on. I think it's bullshit, but it pops up later on. Anyway, I think this is the point where I decide that we're going to try out the hunting minigame, which is one of the minigames we haven't actually checked out so far. And that's started as soon as you get the bow in the mission where you escape Empire City. When you escape out of jail, you pick up a bow while in there. And you don't need... I think you need the bow to start...
Great beast roam these lands.
To start... I love this guy's accent. To hunt them,
you must be keen-eyed and soft of foot.
Soft of foot.
A true warrior. Uses his bow to hunt these beasts.
Hunt these beasts.
Creep close.
Roam these lands.
Send an arrow through their eyes.
Through their eyes.
This is more honorable than a bullet, for it takes great skill and courage.
Yeah, that's why you apparently need the bow.
When you
because
are prepared, seek me out again.
Because apparently using the gun is a pussy option.
I will lead
option.
You down the path of the hunter.
So you need to get sort of get credit for your kills, you need to use a bow. I'm not sure what I'm doing right now, why it's taking me so long to talk to him.
Long have wolves been a plague on our village. They snatch children from their mother's arms.
Wow.
They attack and kill our ponies.
Our ponies?
The first has a coat as gray as smoke. He stalks the white man's towns and farms for easy prey.
For some reason, I get Christopher Walken comes to mind with this guy. Like, the wolves... A plague on our lands. This one is grey as smoke. Tough wolf. My walking is terrible, I'm sorry. So yeah, we're checking out the hunting minigame. And the way it works is... You're not given a specific marker like... the Wanted Posters and Pony Express. All it means is you're giving a vague description as to the area in which an animal has appeared. And a specific animal... spawns in the world, and you've got to kill it, basically. A one-of-a-kind animal spawns in the world, and you've got to kill it. And you've got to kill it with the bow. Now, I've played this game before, like I've already said. I've played it a few times, actually. And I've always done the hunting just with my rifle, because it's fucking easy, because the bow sucks. And you'll find out that it sucks. This is me looking at the map because I was confused because I saw, as you can see on the map down there, there's a quest marker, but that's the story quest. For some reason I thought it was the hunting, but then I realised, oh, it doesn't actually give you a quest marker, it's vague descriptions, go and find it yourself. You've got to actually hunt and track, which is pretty cool. But yeah, I've done the hunting before in this game, and I've always done it with a rifle because the bow sucks, as I've already said. But I'm not sure what the difference is doing it with either a bow or the gun. I think you still get the stat bonuses the same. And up here's a random bandit attack, who are absolutely no match for me because I shot that guy in the middle of talking. And that guy, wow, we'll forget about that headshot miss there. And I actually watching this again. I just passed up some gold. Did you see that? Do I go back and get it? Oh yeah, I go back and get it. There you are. I'm becoming one of those YouTube commentators who says, hey, you missed the gold at 1 minute 38. Anyway, see, I got that gold. Well, the quest is still telling me to do go talk to a guard, but I'm ignoring that. I'm doing some hunting. So yeah, I think this wolf appears in plains near a town. So I think it can spawn around about where I am here now in Empire. I think it can spawn up ahead where the ranch is, because it said it appears near populated areas because it likes to sort of pick off easy prey, you know what I mean? So I think it can hang out near the ranch as well, which I think is what I'm about to check now. Sort of doing some messing around with the UI there. For some reason, you can press the keys 1, 2, and 3 to bring up the pistol, the rifle, and the shotgun, but if you press key 4, that does nothing. That's not the bow. For some reason, you have to Alt and then E to get the bow. And I just killed that random wolf for absolutely no reason. That's not the wolf you have to kill. And you just see ahead there, it just pops into view. I was about to stop and get some gold, but I'm going to capture this guy instead because, well, not capture, this is not Pokemon. Because I think they do despawn. I think there is a timer. Some sort of timer to it once you're in range. So the way it works is you have to get really, really close to get the bow shot off in one. To basically get a one-hit KO, you need to be really fucking close to this guy. So you've got to really sneak up because these special animals get spooked very, very easily. So if you ride upon a horse, the thing's just going to run away. So you've got to get off your horse, you've got to sneak really close and hope you get a one shot, because if you don't, they run. So let's see if we do it in one shot. Do we do it? Nope, as you see, we didn't get it in one shot and the thing just will run and we can't catch it. Pretty much. Yep, it's gone. And that is why I hate using the bow for the hunting, because it never one-shots. And if you don't get the one-shot, the thing just runs, so you've either got to get it really good with a second shot, or, like I said, just use a fucking gun, which is something I might do. And so that's our look at the hunting minigame. It's pretty much just that. The same over in all the missions, I believe. Except it's a different animal with different varying degrees of difficulty on taking them down for a kill. And I decide...
Lee Hop Dong, Chinaman.
I love that. I love that one poster that it says Chinaman for a description. That's great. Tainted opium.
Last seen west of Piper Lake. Known to travel with bodyguards.
I don't know why Colt sort of pauses so much when he's reading these wanted posters. Like, Lee Hop Dong, Chinaman. And, oh, you see that? Like, we have horseception. That was really weird. So, yeah, I think I decided just to do some more side missions for the rest of the episode. Because these side missions are fun. And they actually contribute a lot to the gameplay. Because they give you stat boosts, which will help with later missions. I love that when a game actually makes the side quests necessary to do, you know what I mean? It's not all just for done for money's sake, which is what a lot of games do with their side quests, is it's all just for its own sake. It's all done for money. There's no actual benefit to them, whereas this game, there is. You get stat boosts, which help make the game a little bit easier. The stat boosts you need are not mandatory. They don't make the game impossible if you don't do the side missions, but The game's difficulty does ramp up, and if you don't do the side missions for the stat boost, it can sort of get on top of you a little bit. And there's a random white horse there. I think I comment on just the random fucking horse in the middle of nowhere. I think the owner just got off to take a piss. Maybe. So yeah, I love this game's side quests, and they're very varied. in that it's not all just about fighting people. That, you know, they've got the wanted posters for that, sure. You've got the federal marshal missions. Like the deputy missions for that as well. And then you've also got the ranchers for just herding cattle around and stuff in a little bit more calm. You've got the Pony Express for really hectic time trial, like racing style. And you've got the hunting for a little bit more combat, but it's very skill based. And you've got poker as well. Like I said, this game feels like to me like it's... Oh, here we go. I pull up on the guys and get a sweet combo with the explosive barrel. And that guy is shooting the crap out of my horse. You see that? But yeah, back to the side missions. To me, this game feels like a huge spiritual successor to Red Dead Redemption because they are very, very similar games. They play very similar. Oh, you see that sweet combo? Shot the gun out of his hand and then headshot him. That was a sweet as fuck combo.
Please don't hurt me.
And I love this guy because he doesn't even attempt to fight back. He just gets all his guards to fight here and then just cowers in the corner. And we got him. Fantastic. So yeah, to me this game is pre-Red Dead Redemption. Very similar games, very similar gameplay. It's an open world packed full with minigames, just like Red Dead Redemption is. Red Dead Redemption is obviously more refined. It's a much better and more expansive game than Gun, but Gun is fantastic in itself. And I love that. He just takes the bottle from Port, like, thanks, and then gives it to me, like, ew.
Maybe it's the last time before Magruder comes knocking.
When I was face to face with that one-eyed bastard, he said he knew Ned. Is that true?
Kid, Magruder was our commanding officer in the war.
You're kidding me. What happened, Clay? Tell me.
It was late 64. The Confederacy was desperate. Magruder had convinced Richmond to send us on a secret mission he thought could turn the tide of the war. Find Kivera, an ancient city of gold.
That's not a great plan. How would a city of gold help turn the tide of a war?
Led us to him.
Dr. Campbell, I mean, Major Magruder, Texas.
Anyway, I'll shut up for this.
You're in the wrong place if you're hunting Federals, Major.
I'm not hunting Federals, Doctor. Corporal Allison. Where is the cross?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, look at this guy coming up talking smack.
He says one day you will find what you seek, and that day will be your last.
Jesus!
I have time for games, Doctor.
Stop it, Tom. I never agreed to this. Count it!
You son of a bitch! That cross is no good to you!
I will not be denied!
Oh! Man, Magruder with the combos! Oh, and that lady absolutely fucks him up! Yeah, that's why Magruder now wears an eye patch. Because he took a shotgun shell to the eye. Yeah, that was a grim scene, but...
And I stood up like Ned. Magruder might be in hell instead of back here doing his devilish work.
You mean he's still after Corvera?
The war ended, but his mission didn't. It's his holy grail.
Clay, right before he died, Ned told me he wasn't my real father. You know anything about that?
No, kid, I don't. Except that Ned was full of surprise.
Ray! It's Magruder's militia. At least 20 men on horseback.
Go. I'm in the Gatling gun. Take this sharpshooter. It's done well by me.
Oh, and we get a new weapon here, too. Yeah, we get the final weapon class of the game, which is a sniper rifle. Which is sweet.
I'll be on the Gatling gun below.
It's basically just a rifle with longer range. I mean, it's a sniper rifle.
Vamos, Colton, pronto!
Vamos, Colton! Anyway, I completely fuck up by not following Chavez up there. We'll sort of rectify that later. Anyway, yeah, like, interesting story. In the flashback there, we got information that Ned and Clay and Magruder all knew each other. I mean, we sort of knew that, but we didn't know how. Apparently they were all in the Confederacy. Although, if you notice, back in that cutscene, Ned wasn't wearing the Confederate uniform. He was wearing his normal hunting garb that he always wears. So it makes me wonder, was he actually in the army? Or was he just acting as sort of a guide? I'm not sure. I don't think it ever really explains that point, but that's a minor point. So yeah, it explains to us that they were all working together to find some place called Kivera, an ancient city of gold, whatever that is. And you notice the cross that was in that cutscene is actually the cross we saw in the game's opening cutscene. So that cross obviously has some significance. We don't know what yet, but we'll probably find out later. Anyway, I finally decided to actually get my ass up to where I'm supposed to be. And I get a wombo combo with the shotgun. The shotgun's really good for that, for sort of taking out multiple enemies in one. It's great.
There we go! Ha ha! Yeah!
Oh, it looks like Clay finally got the Gatling gun working. And you've noticed that this whole time there's a cannon on the hill. Hasn't really come into play yet. But it will. And I decided to just cowboy up and go find this guy. There we go. Slam him against the rock. What a way to go.
Cole, get your ass over here!
Oh, and now we get to play with the Gatling gun.
Stay here and hold the fort.
See, the thing actually popped up. We didn't just capture it for no reason. Yeah, we get to play with the Gatling gun.
Let's ride! Here!
So yeah, interesting little flashback. We got little tidbits of story, little tidbits of backstory. That house we saw that they were getting ambushed at is actually the house in the middle of the map. So we don't know what significance that holds, but I'm sure we'll find out later. Anyway, I love the Gatling gun. We're actually going ham bun on these mounted guys. They're nothing to a minigun. I like how the horses all just as soon as their rider dies, they just sort of stop. Like, eh, we'll just stop here. No idea how that guy got that close to me. But he did, just like the rest of them.
Colton!
Yes. Yes.
Port needs to talk to you.
Okay. Port! There we go, there he is.
Did you see that cannon out there?
I did see that cannon out there.
If they finish, that thing ready.
Oh! And it looks like they already did get it ready.
What are we gonna do?
And I just standing like a doofus and get almost one shot by that cannon. Yeah, that thing hurts.
Get behind a rock.
You really, yeah, look at how much damage that thing does. And that was like a glancing blow too. And me, like an absolute idiot, I just completely run in and start taking on the entire army. And somehow, don't tell me how, I survive here. Like, look at my health. Like, look at that. That's just a sliver of health. No idea how I survived. Managed to sweet shotgun jump and we finally die. No idea how I managed to survive as long as I did there, because that one shot and I was dead. Like, I got a sweet shotgun kill on the guy behind the cannon, which was cool. And we decided to play smart this time and get the guy on the cannon. Unfortunately, any nearby guards will just run straight for the cannon and sit on it. So you kind of have to keep clearing them off, which is annoying. But I think they decided to stop gunning for the cannon at this point, so we're fine to cowboy up. Yeah, the only reason why I was on such low health in the first place is that cannon kept messing me up. And I almost got low on, I almost died again there because I was low on health because I was an idiot. I really need to remember to, when I'm using the melee, to remember to grab an opponent, because then they can use them as a meat shield. Which is kind of grim, but Hey, it's a feature in the game, why not utilize it? And we finally killed all the guys, which means we now have a cannon in our possession. So right now we're rocking some heavy artillery. And these guys are absolutely no match for the cannon. You might notice the lack of reloading the cannon. Yeah, you can just absolutely rapid fire that thing, and that was a sweet shot to send that guy flying into the cliff. So yeah, net profit from that mission, we got ourselves a sniper rifle, and we also bagged a cannon.
Captured Clay, up on the ridge. They're taking him to Empire.
It's over now. We're licked.
Bullshit.
Bullshit.
Now we got a howitzer and a Gatling gun. Let's put them to use.
Yeah.
It's no good, kid. They know where we are now. We'll be back tomorrow with twice a man. Then let's do what they don't expect. Attack.
Yeah.
God damn, kid. You're as crazy as Clay.
That's a daring plan. We're not just going to sit there and try and defend an... Oh. For some reason, we get an awesome close-up here. I love Colton's perpetual scowl. That's great. Yeah, so we got a new mission in hand now. We're going to march on Empire and go rescue Clay rather than just sort of hauled out and sort of try and defeat wave after wave of enemies, because eventually we'd probably get swarmed and they'd eventually kill us all. Oh, and here I get distracted by the odd-looking tree roots. No idea why. I'm not really sure what I was doing or talking about at this point. I think I was probably talking about that flashback scene we saw a minute ago. I remember in this original recording, it took me like 5 attempts to actually get my thought out because I kept getting distracted by that mission with the Gatling gun and distracted by all sorts of other things. So I think I'm probably talking about that, actually. I don't remember. Yeah, it was an interesting flashback cutscene. Give us a little bit of insight into all the characters, which is nice. Build character. And Elf, what on earth are you doing, man? Go and talk to Pork. Continue the story. Just sort of jumping on tents and stuff. Okay, so after about 2 minutes of watching me just sort of bumble around that camp, it looks like I eventually decided not to talk to Pork, because I think I decided to leave the next mission by the next episode, so I think I...
Wanted.
I'll shut up.
Lula Bell Siddons, a.k.a. Bloody Bell, for castration of a well-known public servant.
Wow.
It is believed she has fled to the southern plains.
Castration, that's like...
She is sentenced to suffer a similar...
Removing
fate.
People's genitals, right? And all you notice about this wanted poster is you don't get an alive reward. You have to kill her, which is, well, that makes it easier. No doubt. So yeah, it looks like I decided to do some side quests for the rest of this episode because they're nice and fun and they're nice and quick. Yeah, I was just sat watching myself just sort of bumble around the camp for like a solid, like, 2 minutes. What was I talking about? I have no idea. I didn't even listen to the original recording at this point. I just deleted it, so... the original mic recording, I should say. So yeah, we're on our way to do a wanted poster. The first woman we have to kill, I think, which is... You know... Equality. Oh, and we caught up to him. Here we are. Apparently she's got a gang of them. And you'll notice there that she's just sort of peaced out while her goonies tried to get me. Sweet combo with the shotgun again there. And there she is. I try and go for the snipe like an idiot. And I fail the mission because she got away. Which was ridiculous because she was right there. But anyway, attempt number 2. This time I attempt to go straight for her. We decide, fuck the goons. We don't need them. We need to go straight for her. And if you saw there again, she escaped. Even though I was like... less than 100 meters behind her, but oh well, stupid game. Now I attempt to go for the snipe. For some reason, get her goon, which that shot pulled like 4 feet to the left. But this time I play it smart, completely ignore the goons and go straight for her. And I decide to go for the quick draw. I like this girl's look. The cowboy hat and the leather. Yeah. I mean, it is a Western. Of course everyone's going to be wearing cowboy hats and leather. Anyway, sweet. Another wanted poster down. I forget how many there are in the game. I think 10. I think there's 10 levels of every side quest. No idea why I decided to attack that random buffalo. Yeah, here is the house we saw in that flashback, which I think is the center of the map. Yeah, I think I'm talking here about how that house is going to serve some importance later. How it just keeps sort of cropping up everywhere. And I decided to explore this little mine. Which serves no actual purpose, I don't think. I think it appears in a wanted poster mission later on. I say wanted poster, it's bounty hunts. It's the actual term for that. But yes, I think there's 10 missions of each side quest in the game. So 10 hunting, 10 ranches, 10 Pony Express, 10 wanted posters. 10 deputy missions, 10 federal marshal missions, and 10 poker tournaments. And I think I've said earlier, but I am going to be showing them all on screen because they are worth watching. All except the poker tournaments. Those I'm going to do off screen if I'm going to do them at all, which I probably won't because, well, the only reward is money and you don't need to get the money from them because, speaking of money, I actually think I'm checking my money here. Yeah, the only reward from the poker tournaments is money, and money is not hard to come by in this game, but with all the gold around, so I think I'm just going to leave the poker missions, to be honest, because there's no variance between them except possibly a difficulty curve. It's basically just playing the same match 10 times, which that's not that interesting. But I'm going to be showing all the other side missions, and oh, another random bandit attack. Trying out my new sniper rifle. You defeated the bandits. Yeah, I did. The bandits always suck. And they never dress like bandits. Minor nitpick, but they never, like, wear the bandana over their faces and stuff like that, like a bandit would. Like a minor nitpick. And it seems I was riding my horse too hard. So I just sort of let it heal up. Do I do another wanted poster before the end of this episode? Apparently I don't. I think all I do for the rest of this episode now is just go and talk to the Indian trader to buy some items, because we got a hell of a lot of money.
How may I serve you, great warrior?
Again, this guy's voice reminds me of Christopher Walken. How may I serve you, great warrior? And I decide to really maximize my hunting potential by buying the obsidian arrowheads, which increases the damage output, and the true flight bow talisman, which increases the range of the bow, and also makes the arrows fire faster, which I would assume helps the damage output, right? I mean, a faster arrow is going to do a hell of a lot more damage, right? You'd think? I don't know. Anyway, so I think that's all I do for the rest of this episode. So I'm gonna cut it off here. So hopefully next time I won't be doing another post commentary. Hopefully I'll remember to unplug my webcam so it doesn't pick up the webcam mic. But that's gonna be it for this episode. So thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.